गुड इवनिंग ऑल ऑफ यू, माई सेल्फ ओम शंकर यादव, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी, जयपुर। सब्जेक्ट एग्रोनॉमी एंड कोर्स क्रॉप कल्टीवेशन टेक्नोलॉजी, सेकंड रबी क्रॉप्स, द कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ फर्स्ट वीडियो। टुडे टॉपिक इज वीट क्रॉप। इन वीट क्रॉप कल्चरल प्रैक्टिसेज, फर्स्ट इज सीड रेट एंड सोविंग। वीट क्रॉप, सीड रेट ऑफ वीट क्रॉप इज 80 to 100 केजी फॉर नॉर्मल सोविंग। इफ दी सोविंग इन अबनॉर्मल कंडीशंस सच एज लेट सोविंग, सेलाइन एल्कलाइन सॉइल सोविंग, the seed rate is increased and this 125 kg per hectare seed is required. The seed are treated with any fungicides such as thyrum, bavistin, carbendazim, vitavex, etc. and for termite control seed treated with chloropyrifos. The seed is treated with fungicide for any seed-borne disease control such as smut. Smut is controlled by seed treatment with Vitavex, and other diseases are controlled by thyrum, bavistin. The dose of amount of fungicide is 2 to 3 gram fungicide per kg seed is required. And after the treatment of seed, they are used for sowing as soon as possible. In the sowing, the wheat crop are sown in line sowings. The line to line spacing is 22 centimeters, and sowing depth is not more than 5 centimeters. Because the colloptile length of wheat is 4 to 5 centimeter, so dwarf variety is sown up to 4 centimeter depth, and line sowing is prepared by seed drills. And sowing time, the wheat crops are grown in rabi season crop, so the sowing of wheat is depend on temperature. The germination is affected by temperature, so when the temperature reaches as 22 degrees Celsius, then sowing is started. Mostly in North India, sowing is done 15 October to 15 December, and the best time of sowing is November. Late sowing is caused low productivity due to warm temperature in February and March, so timely sowing is prepared. Next is manures and fertilizers. Wheat crop is a heavy feeder crop. It required 20 ton of organic manures, FIM or vermicompost, which applied 20 days before the sowing and well mixed with soils by rotatory or cultivators. After that, the application of chemical fertilizers, nitrogen 80 to 120 kg per hectare, phosphorus 60 to 80 kg per hectare, and potassium 40 to 60 kg per hectare. The amount of fertilizers is depend on soil fertility and crop varieties. Hybrid varieties or dwarf varieties are required more fertilizers than tall and desi varieties. The application of fertilizer, the whole dose of phosphorus and potash, half dose of nitrogen is applied at the time of sowing as a basal dose. and half nitrogen is applied at the time of first irrigation. And next topic is weed control. Wheat crop is affected by all the rabi season weeds. It require it for its control. The two weeding are required. First weeding after the first irrigation as 25 days after sowing by hand weeding, and if required the second weeding after 40 to 45 days after sowing. For the chemical weed control, the application of 2,4-D at the rate of 0.5 kg per hectare at the time of 30 to 35 days after sowing. For the effective control of broad leaf weeds and the use of Isoprotera 1 kg AI per hectare at the time of 30 to 35 days after sowing. For the effective control of narrow leaf weeds, mostly oat, Avena fetva, wild oat. And then irrigation. Mostly wheat grown in India in irrigated condition. It required mostly 6 irrigations. The most critical stage for irrigation is first CRI, crown root initiation, at 21 to 25 days after sowing. Second critical stage is tillering at 40 to 45 days after sowing. Third stage is jointing, 60 to 70 days after sowing. Fourth, flowering, 90 to 95 days after sowing. Fifth, milking, 100 to 105 days after sowing. And duff stage at 120 to 125 days after sowing. These 6 irrigation are required for wheat crop. The irrigation depend upon soil type and varieties. So if 4 irrigation is required, available, 3 irrigation is available, or if only 1 irrigation is available, the irrigation is done at the crown root initiation stage. So the CRI stage or crown root initiation stage is most critical for irrigation. If there are 3 irrigation is available, then the first irrigation at CRI stage, second irrigation at boot stage as 75 days after sowing, and third at flowering stage, and as milking stage. So irrigation is given to availability of irrigation water, soil type and variety of crops. After the irrigation, the harvesting. Wheat crop are harvested in March, April month when the crop are turned to yellow color and the grains are soft to hard. The maturity is judged by hardness of grains and harvesting by manual or by combiner. After harvesting, the crop is well dry, and after threshing and winnowing, grains are stored at 10% moisture, 10% or less moisture content. If moisture is more, above 12% moisture, cause infection of disease and pests. So crop is stored when well dry. And next, the plant protection measures. Wheat crops are affected by some insect pests and diseases. The main insect of wheat crop is termite. Termite which affect or cause damage to the root of wheat crop for its effective control, the seed treatment with chlorpyrifos, and when in standing crop, the effect of termite, the use of 1.25 liter endosulfan per hectare with irrigation water. And next, nematodes. The nematode caused Mollet disease, which causal organism is Estrodera avini nematodes, and seed guard nematodes, ear cockle disease, and tundu disease. The tundu disease caused by Aeguna titici bacteria or Aeguna titici nematodes plus Coronobacterium titici bacteria. The combination of nematode and bacteria caused ear cockle or tundu disease. For its control, for nematode disease control, the seed treatment and the drying of seeds in May-June, open sunlight, and use of carbofuran 3G at the rate of 10 to 15 kg per hectare in soil treatment. And the some disease, the most disease are smut, which caused by rust. For smut control, seed treatment with Vitavex. The 3 gram Vitavex per kg seed is required and seed treated with Vitavex. Smut disease, the symptom of smut is the black powders fill on the grains. And next important disease is rust. The rust are affected wheat when the late sowing late. It impact the crops in February, March. And the three type of rust affected the wheat: the black rust caused by Puccinia titici, brown or leaf rust caused by Puccinia recondita, and yellow or strip rust caused by Puccinia stripformis. The whole effective control of rust: the growing resistant varieties, use of lower dose of nitrogen and high dose of phosphorus, dusting 30 kg per hectare sulfur or spray mancozeb or Zinab at the rate of 2 to 2.5 kg per hectare 2 to 3 times at 15 days interval. And other disease are carnal bunt, which caused by Neosia indica fungi, and hill bunt, which caused by Tillisia foetida fungi, and luge smut, which caused by Astilego titici. For these control, the luge smut is controlled by heat treatment or seed treatment with Vitavex. And the yield, wheat crops are give the yield 40 to 45 ton per hectare in irrigated condition, and in rain fed condition yield is lower than irrigated area. The yield is 20 to 25 ton per hectare. It mostly grown in irrigated condition and high productive varieties. The some important varieties are Raj 3077, Raj 3065. Some varieties are C C306, कल्याण सोना अर्जुन UP215, SD2204, प्रताप हीरा संगम एंड गिरिजा सोनालिका एंड मोर अदर वेराइटीज आर डेवलप्ड. दी हंड्रेड्स ऑफ वेराइटी आर अवेलेबल ऑफ वीट क्रॉप्स फॉर डिफरेंट क्लाइमेटिक रीजन्स. सो इट ऑल अबाउट वीट.